David Yeagley on American Indian conservatism, particularly as it pertains to the Comanche tribe. Here is the latest edition, the February edition of the Comanche Nation News. Look at this cover. Comanche Constitution Day Conference. Comanche Constitution Day Conference. All right, I'll read. It names four people who've gathered to look over the Comanche Nation Constitution, January 16th at the tribal complex. Okay, they had a, I don't know if there was a meeting or what, but there's obviously a picture taking of these, four people in the picture anyway, looking over the Constitution, the Comanche Constitution, and to read the document that governs the Comanche Nation and discuss topics related to it. The Comanche Nation recognizes January 16th as Comanche Constitution Day, and this is the first event to highlight the holiday. Holiday. All right, there are several things here to talk about. We're obviously emulating the United States, although our Constitution, our Comanche Constitution, is in no wise similar to the United States Constitution. The United States Constitution provides for three divisions of government: executive, legislative, and judicial. We just have executive, number one. Number two, in recent years, very recent years, the last 5 years, we had a Constitution Revision Committee sponsored by our budget. We paid them close to $250,000, actually closer to $500,000 over 3 or 4 years to revise our Constitution, to make it better, because it was obviously those in charge felt that it was a great hindrance to our development. I think this is curious that immediately after that we have Comanche Constitution Day, January 16th. I pointed out in another tape some of our issues with the history of our Constitution, how that we were told by the Revision Committee that what our Constitution is based on is a 1934 BIA model that was imposed upon all the tribes out this way anyway, in Oklahoma, the Plains tribes. But apparently the Constitution that we have right now is a modification of that, and people like James Cox, one of the many grandsons of Quanah Parker, he was involved in it, and a couple of other people, and this was back in the 60s. So what do we mean Constitution Day? I just find that remarkable. Now, many times in the past I have asserted that American Indians are conservative by nature, not liberal. Conservative means to conserve, to preserve. It's tradition is what Indians are all about. If we didn't value tradition, we wouldn't even exist as an identifiable people and culture. So the very instinct to preserve who you are and what you are is conservative. That's the definition. How it is that NGO, that is non-government organization, Indian leaders who do not represent their people in elected offices, they are simply members of NGOs, how these people are always sort of corralled together to support liberal causes is a mystery to me. professional Indians in media and in organizational capacities outside the tribe, non-tribal organizations, are always liberal. They're funded by liberals, and they espouse liberal causes, and they advocate liberal causes. Comanche Constitution Day. That's conservative. That is not liberal. I think it's important to get a little bit of a grip on the meaning of our words here if we're going to emulate American politics within our tribe. My goodness, what a contradiction. Remarkable contradiction. The only way to solve that is to look at preservation of that which cannot preserve itself. We're dependent on the government keeping its word to us via the treaties, i.e. money and law, enforcement of the laws of the treaties. If you cannot support yourself, and you're supported by somebody else, that's kind of liberal. Maybe that's what the foundation of liberalism is among Indians, or why liberals are able to appeal to Indians, because Indians are, shall we say, we come across as subsidized. Liberals interpret, and conservatives interpret, our treaty provisions from the U.S. government, from the BIA, as some kind of handout. Well, then it's not a handout. It's the word of America that America promised that American government would provide for us if we surrendered, if we stopped killing people, and basically if we stopped defending what was ours and let them take it. They promised to make a deal with us. They would take care of us. That's what the treaty is about. That's not a handout. We earned that with blood. So I resent highly the idea that treaty provisions are a handout. So we've got a lot of confusion in liberalism and conservatism and the terms, the meaning of the terms. And of course, you know, I have to admit that most Indians in Oklahoma probably vote Democratic just out of tradition. My mother's family was all Democrat. Now all the cousins, my cousins, the children, probably half of them have turned Republican. But we grew up Democrat. That's just our environment, you know, that was what was here at the time. My point is, the instinct of the Indian registers in conservative psychology. That's the important thing. And this is a classic piece of evidence. Comanche Constitution Day. I think that's remarkable, and I will develop more of this at a later time. For now, just understand that Indians are in a mesh of mixed terms: conservative, liberal, Republican, Democrat. We need to understand politics in a more specific, definitive way.